Hello friends, here in this video we will see a problem on calculation of shear stress for an I section. Here is the question. I'll write that in the form of data. An I section beam 350 mm into 200 mm has a web thickness of 12.5 mm and flange thickness of 25 mm. So these are the dimensions given. It carries a shearing force of 200 kN. Shearing force is denoted by F. It is 200 kN. So 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton at a section. Sketch shear stress distribution across the section. So for that, shear stress distribution diagram is what we have to draw. Now, since it is given that we have an I section, we can start the problem by drawing the diagram. Now, here is the I section. I'll mark the dimensions over that. It is 350 mm into 200 mm. So, is the depth here into 200 mm. Next, has a web thickness of 12.5 mm. So web thickness is 12.5 mm. Then, and a flange thickness of 25 mm. So thickness of upper and bottom flange are same, 25 mm. Now, after drawing the I section which is given in the problem, here I have marked all the dimensions. We have to draw the shear stress distribution diagram, and for that purpose we need to know the values of shear stress at different locations. So first I'll start in this way, that since the given I section is symmetric, so here is the y-axis of the I section and its distance from the reference is x bar. So as the given I section is symmetric, therefore x bar will be half of 200, that is 100 mm. Next, y bar will be equal to, it is half of 350, that is the location of x axis, this is also called as the neutral axis, that is 175 mm. Now here is, at this point we have the centroid which is at the intersection of x and y axis. Now in this case, after getting x bar, y bar, we are going to find the moment of inertia about the neutral axis, and also since here we have an I section and we have to draw the stress distribution diagram, so we require stresses at, or we can say shear stresses at various locations. So first we will calculate the shear stress at this location, then here, and then at last at the neutral axis. So now after reaching here, I will say that since MI about neutral axis is given by, we know that the neutral axis is located at a distance of 175 mm from bottom. So am I about this neutral axis that will be given by Ixx is equal to from the complete section, that is BD cube by 12 minus, that is what I am doing here is I am taking the complete rectangle which is having 200 mm width and 350 mm depth. So from this complete rectangle I am going to subtract two small rectangles which is here. So how I'll get the moment of inertia is from the complete rectangle, that is capital BD cube by 12, I am going to subtract the moment of inertia for these two small rectangles. So for them I can write this as the value of width will be from 200 I will subtract 12.5, so that will give me the total width here. So it is 200 minus 12.5, that gives us B, and D is the depth of this small rectangle which is 350 minus, it is 25 plus 25, that is 50. So 350 minus 50, that is 300, so into 300 cube, that is B D cube divided by 12. So here I'll put the values of capital B and D. Capital B it is 200, capital D is 350 minus the terms here, which gives me an answer of this entire term as 421.87 into 10 raised to 6. And after I calculate this, I'll get the answer of Ixx as it is 292.71 into 10 raised to 6 mm raised to 4. So here I have got the value of Ixx. Now I'll say that since shear stress at the junction of flange and web is given by, so now shear stress at the junction of flange and web is given by tau 1 is equal to F A Y bar upon I into B 1. Keeping this as equation number 1. Now here I'll say that F is given in the problem, that was shearing force, so it is 200 into 10 raised to 3 Newton. Next, area. Here we are calculating shear stress at the junction of web and flange, so it means we are calculating at this location. So here the area is area of the flange, that is 200 into 25, and that comes out to be 5000 mm square. Then Y bar. Y bar is, since we want to calculate the shear stress at the junction which is at the flange, so Y bar is the distance of the X axis of the flange and the x axis which is the neutral axis. This distance is y bar, and it can be calculated as, since from bottom it is 175 mm, from the top also this distance is 175, so from 175 I'll subtract half of 25, that gives me this y bar distance. So 175 minus 25 by 2, so that gives me an answer of, it is 162.5 mm. Then only B1 is left here. B1 is the width where we want to calculate the value of shear stress. Here the width is 200 mm. So now once we have found out all values, we can say that put all values in equation number 1. So I'll put the values onto the next page. So we have tau 1 is equal to F. It is 200 into 10 raised to 3. A, it is 5000. Y bar 162.5 upon I, that is the moment of inertia. We have found out this value 292.71 10 raised to 6, that is I, into B1, which is 200. So on calculating this, I'll get the answer of tau 1 as 2.77 Newton per mm square. Now after getting tau 1, to calculate tau 2, here I'll use a relation, that using the relation of shear stress and width of the section. So the relation is tau 1 upon tau 2 is equal to b2 by b1, that is, it is inversely proportional, because if we look into the formula of tau is equal to fa y bar upon ib, if I take all these terms as constants, then tau is inversely proportional to b. That is, if b goes on decreasing, shear stress goes on increasing. That is, at minimum width, shear stress is maximum, and where width is maximum, shear stress will be minimum. So tau 1 is the shear stress at width of 200 mm. Now we want tau 2, and that will be at a width of 12.5 mm, that is here. At this location, I'll say this is 0.1, this is 0.2. So we have found out tau 1. Now tau 2 is at 12.5 mm. So using this special relation, tau 2 will be equal to tau 1 into b1 by b2. Therefore, tau 1 is 2.77 into b1 and b2 values. B1 is 200. B2 is 12.5. So on calculation, I'll get the value of tau 2, and it comes out to be 44.32 Newton per mm square. Now we have found out the shear stress at section 1. Now at section 2, next I'll calculate the shear stress at the neutral axis. So I'll write the formula. Now, since I'll write down maximum shear stress, because it will be there at the neutral axis. Maximum shear stress at the neutral axis is given by, we can directly write the formula, that is tau max is equal to, it is F into A1Y1 plus A2Y2 upon I into B. Now here A1 and A2 values, A1 is the area of the flange, so I'll write down A1 is equal to 200 into 25, which is 5000 mm square. Next, after this, area 2, A2 will be equal to, since I am considering the neutral axis, so I have to consider the area above the neutral axis. So flange was 200 into 25, web it is 12.5 mm width, and height of the web is, it is 175 from total, that is from 175 mm. If we subtract 25, that will give us this height. So it is 12.5 into 175 minus 25, that gives us area 2, and the answer is 1875 mm square. So getting this as area 2. Now y1 and y2 values, therefore y1 will be, it is nothing but the distance between x axis of the flange and the neutral axis. So this distance is 162. We have already calculated 162.5. This is 162.5 mm. Then Y2. Y2 is, now we have this web and the height of the web is above the neutral axis. This is 150 mm. So taking half of this will give us Y2. That is 75 mm. Now I can say that therefore tau max will be, here in the formula we have F was 200 into 10 raised to 3, area 1 5000 into Y1, A1 Y1 plus A2 Y2 upon IB. So I'll go on putting the values. Area 2 1875 into Y2 upon I value, that is 292.71 into 10 raised to 6, and B is nothing but the width of the web, which is 12.5. So on calculation of this, I am getting the answer of tau max as 52.09 newton per mm square. This is the maximum value of shear stress. So now, after getting the values of shear stresses at different locations, I'll plot the shear stress distribution diagram. In this shear stress distribution diagram, first I'll draw the I section, which was given in the problem. Here I'll mark the neutral axis, projecting the neutral axis light. Now, for the shear stress distribution diagram, first I'll draw the vertical line. And here, shear stress is zero at the extreme ends. Next, here I had given this as 0.1. So, tau 1 value was 2.77. So, it will be somewhere here. Tau 1 as 2.77. Newton per mm square. Next, at section 2, here the area is decreasing, so stress will increase, and it will increase up to a value of tau 2, and tau 2 was 44.32 newton per mm square. In a similar manner, since it is an I section, here I'll mark tau 1 and tau 2 at the bottom as well. So, the shear stress variation will be in the form of an arc from tau, it is equal to 0, so tau 1. Next, at the neutral axis, we are getting the maximum value of shear stress, and that is 52.09 newton per mm square. So, at the neutral axis, we are getting tau max 52.09 newton per mm square. Now, so this is the shear stress variation for an I section, or we can say the shear stress distribution diagram, where the shear stress is zero at the extreme fibers at section 1, that is at the junction of where the flange is connected to web, it is 2.77 newton per mm square. Where the area decreases, that is at section 2, the stress is 44.32 newton per mm square, and at last at the neutral axis it is maximum shear stress. And here it will go up to a maximum value. Similarly, here the shear stress will go on increasing up to a maximum value. And with this, we complete the problem.